So I just saw Ready or Not, and wow, was this movie weird. I was more or less expecting a normal horror film that is everywhere in modern day horror, but it's not. It's more of a horror comedy than it is a regular horror film, which is kind of unexpected for the studio it is coming from. But this film has some really good acting and some very well shot scenes. Every shot in this movie is very well done, especially for a modern day horror film made by a big company. And even weirder, this director really isn't known for much. His most well-known film is mainly a short in the film VHS, which was more or less an okay film, but this film was a lot better than what he did with VHS. While VHS was known for being a little goofy, this film goes way goofy with this one because it's really silly at times. The only really major problem I had with this movie is that I really couldn't tell if it was a horror film or a comedy at times. So you could sometimes not tell if you were supposed to be scared or should be laughing at scenes, because some of the scenes were so out there that you really couldn't tell if you were supposed to laugh or you were supposed to get scared. And that creates this problem that makes you think, hey, is this supposed to be a horror or is this supposed to be a comedy? Because some scenes get so ridiculous, like the scenes at the ending, which is going to be a spoiler, that they explode at the end. It was just like so weird and so goofy. It was just out of nowhere too. So you knew it was coming, but it's just so insanely dumb that it makes you laugh. But I don't know if it was supposed to make me laugh or it was supposed to be scary. I don't know. And that brings up another problem I have. Why did he try to kill her right at the end of the movie for no reason? It came out of nowhere and it felt a little bit forced. And the film just felt way too short for its idea, so it ruined it a little bit. But besides that, this film was pretty well made, and it was one of the best horror films I have seen this year. It's probably going to be better than It Chapter 2, but I think any but thing is going to be probably better than that movie, from what I've heard about it. And nice to see you guys. See you guys later. And I'm sorry this video seems really short. It's because I'm very far behind on my one video, and it will be coming out next week. That video will be on Godzilla King of the Monsters, of all things, which you might have heard that I already have reviewed, but I'm going to be doing a full-length review that's around 16 to 17 minutes long. And it's going to be my first future kind of more like a regular YouTube video style editing, because it's going to be a lot higher edited than my normal videos. And then I'm going to be working on a documentary in the background, which might be coming out next month. And that will be on the Video Nasties. And it will be coming out next month, most likely. And it's going to take a while, but I'm excited to make that one. It's in the back. And I give this film the final score of a 7 out of 10.